Do you think there may be water in your gas tank and desire to remove it? In older vehicles with rusted gas tanks and poor tank breathe, water in the gas tank is very typical. However, newer cars can also experience these issues. Unfortunately, as you are probably already aware, cars cannot run on water, and your car will not be happy if you have water in your gas tank. However, how can you tell if there is only a tiny amount of water in the gas tank and how do you get it out? These questions will be covered in this video. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. A rough acceleration or misfires are the most typical signs of water in the gas tank. A check engine light on your dashboard or white steam coming from the exhaust pipe are additional indicators. These symptoms will give you a quick overlook even though they probably didn't help you all that much. The most frequent indications of water in gas tanks are listed in more detail below. Water in gas tank symptoms. Rough idle, acceleration and misfires. Rough acceleration is likely the symptom of a water in the gas tank that is seen the most frequently. The air-fuel mixture in the combustion chamber will be extremely weird because the engine believes the water to be fuel. You may also observe misfires when the water enters the combustion chamber of the cylinder because of the problems we discussed earlier, as misfires can result in rough acceleration, but you can also notice misfires on idle. As a result of the improper air-fuel mixture and the misfires, a rough idle is another typical symptom. At idle, the car engine is more prone to making small mistakes, and this is when you'll most likely notice signs of water in the gas tank. Check engine light. All engine sensors in modern cars are continuously monitored. If one sensor is reporting incorrect values, it will communicate this information to the engine control unit, which will then store a trouble code in memory, and, if the issue is serious, may occasionally illuminate the engine light. It's time to check the trouble codes with an OBD2 scanner if the check engine light is on in your dashboard. Steam from the exhaust. If water is present in the exhaust pipe or the combustion chamber, it will evaporate and produce steam. We all probably know that water will turn to steam when heated above 100 degrees Celsius. Therefore, if you notice that the exhaust pipe is emitting a lot more steam than usual, it may be due to water in the gas tank. Slow acceleration. All of the car's sensors work together to maintain a constant, ideal air-fuel ratio. The sensors will receive a false reading if there is water flowing through the engine, causing it to run too richly or too leanly. As a result, the engine's power may be reduced, which may result in symptoms like sluggish acceleration. Hard starting condition. Any car engine startup phase is extremely crucial. The fuel mixture must be almost perfect, otherwise, the spark plugs won't have enough fuel to ignite the fuel or they won't be able to ignite it at all. It's terrible for the starting condition if there is water in the gas tank, and you might have trouble starting it. Check this if you notice prolonged cranking times. The engine does not start at all. If there is too much water in the fuel, the engine won't even start. In addition, if your engine won't even crank, it may be hydro-locked. When the pistons attempt to compress the air in the cylinder, they will also attempt to compress the water, which is impossible, because water cannot be compressed like air can. This could even harm the engine's internals, such as the crankshaft rods, and cause the engine to completely lock up. It takes a lot of water in the chamber, which is uncommon, for this to occur. If you believe this to be the case, take out one spark plug to make sure the crankshaft can still be turned after that. The problems appear after the car has been standing for a while. When the car is standing for a while, the water settles at the bottom of the fuel tank and the fuel floats on top of it. Fuel and water are combined during fuel pump operation. The water will be at the bottom of the tank if the car has been standing for some time. What will happen if the car has been running for a while since most fuel pumps suck the fuel from the bottom of the tank? Yes, the fuel pump will only supply the engine with water. How to get the water out of the fuel tank? Now that you are aware of the signs and the causes, you can be certain that your gas tank contains water. It's time to learn how to get rid of it at this point. Depending on how much water is in the fuel tank, there are a few different solutions to this problem. Here are some suggestions. Empty the tank and replace the fuel filter and refill. The best way to get rid of water from a gas tank is to vacuum empty it, swap out the fuel filter, and then refill it. You'll need a vacuum machine to remove every drop of water from the tank, so it's best to delegate this task to a mechanic shop that has one of these machines. You can also use the built-in fuel pump to remove it, but keep in mind that there may still be water on the bottom because the fuel pump is frequently installed a few millimeters above the tank's bottom. Don't forget to replace the fuel filter once you're finished. Fill with a bit of methanol or special fuel additives. If you suspect there may be a small amount of water in the fuel tank, you can try to remove it by adding methanol or a special fuel additive designed for this purpose. Keep in mind that this only works if you have a small amount of water and will not remove large amounts from the fuel tank. To make sure that you are not harming the engine or other components, carefully read the instructions. If you decide to try it with methanol, use it sparingly and with extreme caution. Hope this information was useful for you. If so, please subscribe to the channel and press the like button.